This video is protected by fair use. It's for teaching and research purposes, and it's not for profit. It's fair use. Hey everyone, hope you're doing well. Gonna be doing an analysis video, commentary, and I'm gonna be proving something here. There's been people coming to the Sanity Machine channel, coming over from the Creature on the Screens channel, Forever Con Man channel, and some of them are moderators on his channel, in his chat room. And they've basically been accusing me of being a liar without coming right out and saying that. But they have been rude and saying, do you even watch the videos of his videos? Yes, I've seen him say what I'm accusing him of saying. And I have the evidence. I have some evidence right here. I'm not willing to sift through 15, 20, 50 hours of his videos, because his, as I've mentioned before, his voice is like a knife to my brain. But actually, I took the time tonight and suffered through some pain to find this video and to find some clips of him saying certain things about consent. Okay? And this is what I've been saying that he's been pushing for over a year, and he has been pushing it. And you can question it all I want. Some of you are moderators on his channel, and you don't have a clue what you're talking about. You don't have a clue who you're working for free. I realize you're not being paid by him, but you're moderating for free for someone that's pushing something, and you're not even aware of what he's doing. So I'm going to show you some evidence. So you basically accuse me, and you defend him at every opportunity. And I've been very tolerant, especially with one moderator in particular from this Creature's channel, that has basically said nothing kind, nothing good on my channel for the most part. And every time I post a video, a parody video or whatever type of video that involves the creature, this creature that's on the screen, the parasite, they've automatically, immediately posted a comment in its defense. And I'm going to call it an it, okay? If it's an it, I'm going to call it an it. And that's what it is. And I see through it, and I'm going to back up my statements here tonight, okay? So what I'm going to do is show you some evidence, so it's going to shut some mouths on my channel, and if you keep yapping after being shown the evidence, then I am going to ban you. And it's not because of a difference of opinion, it's because you won't look at the evidence, and that's where the problem lies. And then you're not wanted, because you're just being rude, and you're biased, and you're brainwashed. But you've also been rude to me multiple times in comments. And I basically, I guess I'll say I tolerated it temporarily, giving you a chance to learn something, to learn some truth, to get out of this cult. Because you came over to my channel, so you're on my channel, and I'm giving you a chance to learn something. If I were you, I would take the opportunity to learn something. You don't have to. But then you're not wanted. If you're not on my channel to learn, then I don't want you. Why would I? Why would I just want you to put up, why would I want you on my channel and just put up with comment after comment? I put up with a couple, but that's it. You know, I draw the line. So one more and you're gone. One more stupid, rude comment like, do you even, with that kind of attitude, and you're fucking gone. And you can go back to this shill channel. And you can get brainwashed, and you can get brainwashed about consent, and you can go right into the recycling bin. Not because I want that, because you're choosing that. How are you choosing that? By rejecting the truth, and rejecting the evidence, and defending a creature. A creepy boy. A creepy boy. Okay? So, that's up to you. But, yeah, this video is for you. This video is dedicated to you. And it's not about being skeptical. It's about, hey, you got a rudeness issue, okay, for one thing. Another thing, you treat people like they're a liar because they're making claims just because they don't snap their fingers and have, I don't have hundreds of hours of evidence right at my fingertips. I have to look for this stuff. I remember him saying it, but I don't have it recorded until tonight. So now you're going to see some evidence, and it's real evidence, and it should shut your mouth, because you're wrong, okay? what you were saying in comments on my channel defending this creature. You're wrong. What I was saying is true. So here we go.
Replay viewers, hello everyone. Welcome back to Forever Conscious Research Channel. Hope you're doing well today, and if you celebrated the holidays, you had an enjoyable one. Tonight's video will be on near-death experiences. We're specifically going to be going into the return to the body deception. So with that, we're going to see.
I want to jump in just for one moment. Deception, he said, return to the body deception. Some of you, I hate to say this, but you're at a low level. You better look up what consent means, because you don't understand what it means. Consent doesn't have to do with being deceived, conned, tricked, forced, coerced, pressured. That's not consent then. You better inform yourself about what real consent means before you argue. Before you leave a stupid comment that's tedious for me to read and reply to, okay? This channel is a high-level channel. What do I mean by that? It's not for morons. It's not for people that don't understand basic things like consent. Inform yourself about the meaning of that, okay?
Some examples, and it's a specific one on consent, as well as a lot of just messing around, people giving away their sovereignty and just going along with the show, not questioning things. And, you know, even the example I give you with consent, I mean, if you really want to look at it, you can say, oh, well, you know, hey, even though she brought up consent, you know, she's in this scenario where she's being deceived. But, you know, the way I see it is there are tons of examples on how consent and intention play a massive role in all of this. If I, for 1 minute, felt that consent and someone's intention wasn't the keys to the kingdom, I don't even know if I'd be doing these videos. Okay, I have spent a number of years looking at this, and nothing concerned me more than when I was looking at NDEs where we hear people saying they were forced to come back. Okay, that type of thing really did not sit well with me, and kind of my main reason why I didn't even go to as deep as I did on this topic until, you know, the end of last year, even though I discussed it as far back as I think 2 or 3 years ago, maybe. What I'm trying to say is we see the consent factor, we see it now.
Okay, I'm jumping in here. Did you catch that, or do I have to replay it for you? This guy's a believer in that we consented to come here. Got it? Did you get that? So instead of questioning me and saying, do I even listen, or all that stuff, that rude shit with an attitude and a bias towards defending this creature on my channel and comments on my videos, did you catch that? Are you paying attention? Are you listening? Are you listening? I wish I could say this to you in person, because you've been a rude ass on my channel, and I've been telling the truth. So instead of questioning a liar like the creature on the screen, you come on my channel and try to treat me like I'm a liar. You got things ass backward, lady. You got that? You have things ass backwards. So flip things around in your head. You've got it inverted. I've been telling the truth about this creature, and now I'm showing you some evidence to back up those claims. I already showed evidence of the grifting, but he's doing more than grifting, and some people haven't caught on to that part yet. And it really is tedious. It really is. That's why you hear the frustration in my voice. Because I don't want to have to spend my time doing this shit. You can prove this to yourself. This might be the last time I do this. Spending the time to find this shit. Because I know what he said. I heard it. I remembered it. I can quote him on stuff. If you don't want to believe it, fine, leave my channel. I'm showing you evidence, though, right here. But I don't think I'm going to do this every fucking time that I'm doubted on my channel. I think I'll just ban people that are like that, that are rude. It's not a disagreement or a different opinion. It's a matter of truth. I'm telling the truth about this creature. You're defending him, and you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. He promotes that we consented to this. Just as I said.
Two or three years ago, maybe. What I'm trying to say is we see the consent factor. We see it. Now, why I want to address this is because in the last video with Wayne, he had brought up a letter that was written to him from someone that I personally dealt with, who I spent a lot of time with. And who was, frankly, very rude and obnoxious.
I know who they're talking about. That person actually emailed me. That person, I believe, contacted me on Dan's channel, Overwatch. And I remember the part, I don't know the timestamp of it. I can't remember that, but it's in a Wayne Bush video where Wayne Bush is on Forever Con Men channel. And they brought up the email and the consent factor. And Bush, Wayne Bush and this creature on the screen are both in agreement on the whole consent thing. And so is Dan from Overwatch. They're the big three shills. They're all in agreement. They're all on the same page that we consented to this. All right? Look into it for yourself instead of arguing on my channel. Because I don't have time for that tedious shit. I don't have the energy and I don't want to. It's tedious. It's annoying. Okay, and also to the moderator from this channel, lady, you better learn proper spelling and grammar when you're basically saying, do you even listen? You don't even know proper English, and you're trying to argue with me. So maybe you should stick to being a moderator on this creature's channel, because maybe you're at that level. You're not at the level of my channel. You're just not. So don't ever say to me, do you even listen to? I listened to this creature's videos for months. I know what I'm talking about. And you're moderating on his channel, and you don't even know what his philosophy is. Okay? You're doing work for him in his chat room. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. You don't know what he believes, what he's pushing. You're that clueless. You're that brainwashed. You're that biased in this cult. Okay? That's what you are. So I'm going to start calling people out on that shit. Don't ever leave comments on my channel like that. The nasty attitude and insulting and rude saying, do you even watch his stuff to say that he said? Yeah, I do. Okay. I pushed through listening to this creature's atrocious voice for months. And I heard him say it many times. Many times. Maybe you're asleep. Maybe you're talking in your sleep when you're posting comments on my channel because you don't know what the fuck you're talking about. All right, lady? Talking to the moderator from this creature's channel. You better wake up or you're headed for the recycling bin and you're not even aware of it because you're believing shit that's false that's going to be used against you when you leave your body and you kick the bucket. They're going to use all of that against you, all of it. And I'm actually helping you by telling you that. I'm telling you the truth. And you don't get it. You just don't get it.
And that's not to put aside the contents of the letter. It just goes, it has to be said because of who I was talking to. Okay, I was very generous with my time talking. Not like I'm some big shot or anything, and I'm not all about ego, but point is, I talked to him because, you know, he's going through a lot of dark stuff, and we a lot of people are at this time, and I understand that, and I respect that, and I empathize greatly with that. But, you know, I don't know how long he's been looking into this. He never told me he wouldn't talk down in voice mic or anything like that, voice chat.
Okay, so he's I'm defending someone I don't even like. I don't like that character, that guy, Akuna, A-Q-U-N-A, is his alias, has been rude to me, nitpicked at my videos. I think I banned him from my channel. But he did make valid arguments, okay, in his email to them. And he made valid arguments in email to me. But he acted like an asshole in comments on my channel multiple times, and then I was done with him. So, but this creature on the screen, this thing painted the guy as new, painted him as dark and going through stuff. I think that's wrong to do. He's poisoning the well, basically, by painting him that way instead of just addressing the guy's arguments. So what if he's new? I don't know if he's new or not. I don't know how long he might have been researching this for a year, 10 years. Who knows? I don't know. But in one sense, it's not relevant in the sense that he made some valid arguments. And as I said, I don't even like the character. So I'm not really defending him because, oh, I like the guy. I banned the guy from my fucking channel, all right? Recently, like within the last week or so. Just recently. He's one of the ones that got banned. So really, I don't have any bias for the character. He nitpicked at one video, and then another video, he was insulting and rude and name-calling me or something. I was like, fuck, I'm done. Fuck you, you know? Got rid of him. I don't need that. But anyway, regardless, moving on here.
You know, and after multiple times, I even said, oh, you know, maybe we can get a microphone over to you. Point is, he seems to have a problem with the consent thing.
Fair enough. Okay.
Just for one moment, a lot of us have a problem with the consent thing. And if you carry on watching this video, which a lot of you apparently don't do, but if you watch to the end, I'm going to show some screenshots about consent of comments that I've left and that other people have left. A lot of us don't buy the consent thing that we consented, including some former moderators from this creature's channel, like Vince. It was a pretty well-known moderator on this channel, all right? So a lot of us have an issue with the whole we consented thing. It's not just me, and it's not just that Akuna guy, okay? And there's people on Dan Overwatch channel in the comments there on his videos, older videos and new videos, that had taken issue with him pushing the we consented thing. It's all over YouTube. There's people all over YouTube that have an issue, that don't buy this bullshit that's being pushed, that we consented. There's a lot of us, and it's a growing number, all right? But you know what? I'll put this out there, too. Even if it was just me, which it isn't, but if it was, hypothetically, I would stand by this 100% and go against the whole quilt community if I know that I'm right. If I know that we didn't all consent to this. If I know that there's coercion, force being used, which removes consent if you look into it, okay? Just like if you're signing a contract on Earth, if I have a gun to your head, hypothetically, not real for real, but in this scenario, then there's no consent. Same thing with grape, if you know what I'm saying. I have to put it that way. If there's force and violence, there's no consent. It takes away consent, even if the person says yes. Do you understand this? So the same should apply to the quote afterlife. If there's lies, trickery, force, coercion, threats, all that duress, all that shit, then it's not consent. I have to rewind that part. Please replay it. Don't leave a stupid comment talking about trickery and then we consented, we were tricked. Those are two different things, for fuck's sakes. Do you not get that? don't get it. Some of you don't, especially the moderators from this creature's channel that migrated over to mine and are commenting. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. You don't know the meaning of consent. Go to Notes for Materiality channel on YouTube. There's a link on my channel. Go and watch this video about not withdrawing consent because he didn't give consent. It's an excellent video. It will teach you a lot. I was aware of the meaning of consent before I watched it, but not the finer points. So I'll watch something 3 times or more just to make sure I get it 100%. You might call me obsessive. You can call me whatever you want. But when I want to understand something, I really want to understand it. And I think there's a lot of morons in this quote community that don't give a shit about understanding the meanings of the words they use, like consent. And it's important to understand what that word means if you're going to toss that word around in comments. Because you sound foolish when you leave comments on my channel saying, well, Mark's saying we were tricked, but we consented. The fuck are you talking about? It's like saying, well, we had a gun to our head, but we consented. That's not consent then, you dumbass.
Like I said, I had a big issue with the people who say they were, quote, forced to come back. Okay, that's a big issue. But if you start looking at it's you can't just pick one thing. You have to look at the overall picture. There's a big thing. There's a big point to be made in the person's life too. Okay, the person's background that they share with you. How embedded in the system are they? Okay. How free do they come off? Now, mind you, we're talking about.
I have to jump in again. I'm sorry, but if you're forced back here, that's not consent. I know he has a big issue because he doesn't want to believe that that's happening, or he's an agent. It's one or the other. Either he can't handle it, he does not want to recognize and acknowledge that some people were forced here in their pre-birth memories. Just like Veronica mentioned in the pre-birth memory she had of the video that I analyzed, she mentioned seeing spirits that were forced back here, that didn't want to come here. And that's not uncommon. That is pretty common. Not the way she put it, but the way Harold said it too. There are other ones that mention, there's lots of NDEers too that mention that they're forced back here. Okay? But it's just always good to have that evidence when somebody comes out and says that. Now, why would Veronica, I believe her, okay, I'll just put that, I put that out there in the video, and I'm saying it again now, okay? I do believe her, that she was being honest about what she remembers. If you're listening, Veronica, I do believe you. And I do believe what you witnessed and what you experienced, and that you witnessed other spirits being forced back here. We're in an evil realm, okay? Does that need to be proven to people, or can you see that much by now? You know, I'm not talking about Veronica. I'm speaking about other people. By the way, I don't know if I've mentioned this. I think I have in videos. My memory is not that great, I wanted to say. I believe I've mentioned this in videos, that I've been in contact with Veronica in emails and chatted with her and stuff like that. She is a cool person. Okay. I did get something wrong about suffering. She has suffered in her lifetime tremendously. She's gone through suffering. And I do believe that she cares about the suffering of others. What threw me off in that analysis of that part was she was so excited to come to Earth. And for some reason, I guess in my mind, this is my explanation. I'm not justifying it because I was wrong on that part. Most of my analysis, I would say 70-80% or higher, was pretty accurate. I won't say correct, I'll just say accurate with hers, okay? I'm just talking about that particular video, that analysis that I did. But there's the 10 to 20% where I think I said, I don't think she suffered, or I can't, you know, can't remember my wording on it, exact wording, but I said I had trouble thinking that she suffered because she just seemed so bubbly and excited and jumping around and almost like a Mexican jumping bean, just jumping around and almost coming right out of her skin to come to Earth. This is a dark realm of fucking evil and suffering. Is there beauty here? Yeah, there's joy, there's beauty. You know, there's acts of kindness, there's beauty in nature. Not all of nature is beautiful. I can show you lots of ugly spots in this realm. So you can't just use a blanket statement. Nature is beautiful. All of it? Nope. Nope. Let's be honest here. A lot of it isn't. Is nature brutal too? Not just beautiful, but brutal? Yep. Hurricanes, tornadoes, earthquakes that kill thousands, for example, blizzards. What about all the deadly animals, the poisonous plants, mushrooms, poisonous berries, fruit? You can go on. Like, life eats life every second of every day, all day long, all year long, here. Brutally, it kills to survive. Life eats life. That's the design of nature. That's the realm we're in. So just to call it beautiful, man, you're way off on that. That's like a kindergartner's view. In fact, there's kindergarten kids that know that there's brutality in nature, so they know more than you do. They'll talk about sharks and stuff like that, and, you know, predators and lions. They're aware of that, and you don't even speak of that. So there's people that are so far gone saying nature's just beautiful. It can be beautiful, but it's also brutal beyond words. But anyway, Veronica has suffered. I'm not going to give away anything confidential, but that part I did have wrong on my analysis. So if you want honesty, that's what you're going to get here at the Sanity Machine. I'm not hyping myself up. I just aim to be honest because I'm aiming at getting at the truth here. And that includes us not consenting, which is a touchy subject because most of these shill channels just keep saying we consented. They don't want to say what I'm saying. You notice that? I'm saying different things than what they're saying. And I was saying it, and I'm going to prove it in this video with the screenshots later on, that I've been saying this for months. Months and months, okay? I didn't just start saying this tonight. I've been seeing through this whole sham that we all consented for a long time. Am I stopping you from going to these shill channels and getting brainwashed and just filling your heads up with bullshit? No, I'm not going to. I can't stop you. You can go here and you can sit here and you can just go to the cult channels and you can just load up if you want to. But you've been warned. You've been shown some truth here.
Frenendees, I think they're all dealing with deception. But when we're talking about things like DMT, ayahuasca, pre-birth memories, yeah, there's deception there. But the point is we see it live and in action when people are outside their body and DMT, ayahuasca, and various other breakthrough trip reports, even mushrooms, you know, talking about big doses, where they are in an uncomfortable situation or perhaps even a boring situation that is not, you know, they're just, they want out, okay? And all they do is think about it, and boom, the scenery changes. They set their intention, you know, oh, I don't like this scenario. I want to get out of it, okay? Now, they don't necessarily know the true powers that they have, but the point is they feel it so deep inside with them that everything changes on a dime. And there are tons of those. You can go dig through them and find them yourself.
Going to jump in here. I don't want anybody that's watching this video or listening to my voice to warp things that I'm saying. Don't put words in my mouth. I've never said that we don't have the power of intention, that our minds are not powerful, that our spirits are not powerful. I've never said any of that. So don't ever come at me with comments like, oh, don't you think that we're powerful beings? No, I've never said that we're not. Now some of you are scratching your heads, but you're saying, like, it doesn't add up to you, does it? Like, you just can't get it. Just can't get it. Because you know what? It's kind of complex. It's not as simple as the shill channel spin things. You might have to think a little bit. I've never said that we're victims. I've never pushed victimhood. I've never said that we're helpless. I've never said anything that some of these shill channels try to paint the soul trap, or not paint me specifically, but paint this quote community, or paint the belief of how the reincarnation soul trap works. So there's a whole bunch of shit put out there to muddy the waters. That's why they do it. That's why shills do this shit. Deceivers, snakes, gatekeepers, liars, frauds. You tell just talking about this shit makes me sick. That I don't even want to do it. I don't enjoy this. But I really get tired of the fucking comments from certain people that have migrated right from here. Right from this creature's channel. Right from here. Okay? And I'm familiar with the names from months ago, by the way. I was in here before I got banned. All right? Last summer is when I got banned. But I'm familiar with these names and many more. And I still watch this once in a while. I'll keep an eye on this shit. And I just saw somebody saying something about me recently in there. All right? So once in a while, they do mention my name in there. Still, I haven't been in there, you know, since what, last June or July, something like that. Last summertime. And they're still talking about me in there. And once in a while, they mention my channel or, you know. I am the bad guy. I am the bad boy. I'm not part of this, quote, community. I'm the outsider. And I'm exposing them all. All of them. So put that in your pipe and smoke it. To all of his defenders. Not his. What am I talking about? Its defenders. This thing.
I've shown countless examples of consent and how it works on this channel.
Did you get that? Did you get that? Do I have to repeat it? I know that repetition is a basic and effective form of mind control, and it's so sickening that I almost have to repeat shit. I'm almost ready to go to that level with some people. Not to mind control you, but it's just like you don't seem to get it when you hear it. And you're insulting to me, and yet I'm telling the truth. And you're defending this fucking creature, saying that he doesn't push consent. He doesn't push consent. Oh, he doesn't? He doesn't? He doesn't? He makes fucking videos about it, okay, that are hours long. Hours long. Almost 3 hours. 2 hours and 53 minutes and 54 seconds. You got it? You got it, lady? So can you stop with the fucking comments before I have to ban you, which I haven't wanted to do, because you did come over to my channel. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe she wants to learn. Maybe she's going to open her mind up and get out of this cult. I know you're a moderator in this shit chat. That's what I'll call it. I'll call it a shit chat, the shill chat. How about that? The shill chat. That's what I'll call it. So people that think they know everything when they came right out of here, you got a lot to learn. Got a lot to learn. I was warning you last summer about this stuff. And nobody in here believed a damn word I said back then. But now some of them are coming over onto my channel. I keep seeing names from here coming over. And they're starting to open their eyes and open their mind a little bit about this creature. But I was warning you last summer. You know, and there's other stuff I could warn you about. You might be 6 months behind or a year or years behind on some other stuff. It's not me boasting. It's the fact that you were insulting to me a lot of times. A lot of people in this chat were insulting towards me and doubting me on things I was saying. And if I said the truth, they'd attack me and mock me and name call and do all kinds of stuff. They never got warnings. They never got banned. They'd gang up. And I would defend myself. And I was speaking the truth. So that's what I do, not just on this creature's channel and that chat room, but other places too. You could speak the truth on the Archaics chat, and they'll gang up on you there too and ban you. Can't speak truth for even 1 minute without getting banned over there. And Boopster is a moderator. She's not shown right on this screen here, but she's a moderator in this chat. She's a moderator on Archaics too. It's the same faces. It's the same people moderating on all these shill channels. A lot of times it's the same ones, familiar names. And what's their role? To prevent the truth from coming out. That's what their role is. So if you can't see the difference on my channel, you got big issues, real big mental issues. I'm not joking. I'm not saying it as a put down. Please get help, because I never push the false we consented on my channel. But this creature does, and Dan from Overwatch channel does, and I've got comments, I've got screenshots of him commenting to me, pushing it. Okay? I've got proof. And what do you defenders have? You don't have proof. You have stupidity. You're talking out of your ass. You don't know what you're talking about. So if I were you, I'd shut your mouth and start listening and learning something before speaking bullshit, because you don't know what you're talking about. I'm going to play that again, just in case you missed it, because I really want you to open your ears and hear it. Especially the moderator that said, do you even listen to what he's saying? Do you listen? How about you listen, lady? Open your ears up.
List examples of consent and how it works on this channel.
Did you get that?
A dime, and there are tons of those. You can go dig through them and find them yourself. I've shown countless examples of consent and how it works on this channel. I show how I bring this. The one of the best examples I put out was the near-death experience from Tony. Okay, Tony had he got struck by lightning, ended up becoming a concert pianist. You know.
Wild near-death experience. You can look back on when I did that three, 4 months ago. Anyways, you see a moment right after he gets struck by lightning and left his body. He feels he's pure existence, blah, blah, blah. He's just chilling, doing his thing. Then all of a sudden, he's going moving along and sees a blue orb and is attracted to it. So there's a moment when Tony gets struck by lightning, he's doing his own things. I think he even said he didn't have like a care in the world, no worries, nothing. And then all of a sudden, he sees that blue ball light, which we can equate to something similar like the white light, okay? And he goes towards it. He chooses to go towards it. And then everything changes. The whole situation changes. Why is that? Because Tony was a pure existence state, his pure spirit essence, we can say. And then all of a sudden, he got attracted by that blue light, and then everything,
the whole thing just went nuts. Okay,
he went through a whole situation, ended up coming out of it a concert pianist, just wild, wild stuff, okay? And then
Past-life regressions, okay?
Where we hear it time and time again, consent. And then we even hear it in NDEs where people will admit openly that,
I consented to come back. You know, I consented to do this.
Okay? But it's important that we identify and see the examples where us as
true creator beings have the power to call the shots.
Now, I will say that the most important moment that we have
is at the time of death. That.
Okay, I'm just going to pause it right here for a moment because I want to show some other stuff before this gets too long. Bear with me, please. Okay, as you can see, this is a comment by me, the Sanity Machine, 5 months ago. And this comment I screenshotted, it's from Christopher Sedaris' channel. And he actually hearted the comment. All right. So maybe he hearts every comment. This is before he banned me. He banned me from his channel for speaking the truth about Matt McKinley and about Archaix the Grapist. And I spoke the truth about both of them. And I backed it up with evidence and emails, which he's never admitted to on his channel. All he did was slander me and name call me and ban me. That's all he could do. Is curse and swear and do the stupid. He's a felon, okay? Christopher Sedaris is a felon. And he's admitted to that on video. Anyway, I've been telling the truth about this for many months. It goes back before 5 months ago. Been doing this for a long time. But there's some evidence, all right? There's some evidence. All right, here's another screenshot. When I spoke about other people that see it on other channels, I've have other screenshots. I can't do hours and hours of video, but I have more than this. There's people that see, hey, if you do the research, you'll notice that there's a large number of cases that were forcefully returned to their bodies without consent. I'm not the only one that sees this. I'm going to repeat that. I'm not the only one that sees this. All right. Yet again, this person posted this comment 7 months ago. So much for choosing to come here in free will. So some people do see it. I believe this might have been on Dan's channel, Overwatch Project. So yet again, I'm not saying that I'm the only person on YouTube that sees this. Others see it too. I'm not alone, and I'm not claiming to be alone. All right? Okay. Here's a comment. This is another public comment by Vince on a video on my channel. It's a response video, an analysis video by me, as you can see. Forever Con Man Research. Obviously, you know what I call that creature, so, and his channel. So you can see that's on my channel. And that's Vince's comment. And he used to be a moderator on Forever Con Man Research. And Vince wrote, "Hi, I don't believe that we consented to be here. As dark as it may seem, I tend to think that we were forced for several reasons." And he goes on. Do you see what I'm saying? You're starting to see a little bit of a pattern. And some of you are having a real eye-opener here. Oh, wait a second. The sanding machine's not the only one. And there's lots more. There's lots more screenshots that I could take. But you know what? I'm not going to dedicate my whole life to taking screenshots to prove things to people that are brainwashed, that aren't open-minded, that want to argue and want to be rude. Want to buy the lies? Go ahead. All right? I've been working my ass off on my channel, and this is just the truth, to try to share the truth with people and to try to share a different perspective. And you wouldn't believe how many people I've had to get rid of that are just rude, nasty, really nasty, and also ones that are just so fucked up. They're not just brainwashed. They're fucked up to the point that they'd say, "Well, what's the difference between your channel and your belief, Sanity Machine, and Forever Con Man? I don't see any difference." The fuck are you talking about? You know how many major differences there are that are clear, should be clear? I shouldn't have to point them out. You should be able to do that on your own. If you can't do that, you're in trouble. I don't know if you understand what I mean. Like you must be at such a level that I even have to explain that. If you can't tell the difference between my views and his views and what he pushes and what I do on my channel, and it's beyond grifting. It's way beyond just the donations, grifting, memberships, the money, the private consultations that he does, all kinds of stuff, his money-making grifting schemes. It's beyond that, the differences that we have. It's not just difference of opinion, okay? You're in trouble if you don't see the differences. You really are. Because you're going to be duped so fucking easily by these creatures. Because you can't even see the difference between, like, I mean, you're mental. I don't know what you're looking at. You're looking at red and blue, and you're saying they're the same, basically. You're looking at a pineapple and an orange, and you're saying they're the same. Looking at a watermelon and a grape, and you're saying they're the same. You have issues. If you can't tell the difference, if you're seeing sameness where there's tremendous difference, you're looking at an anthill and looking at Mount Everest and saying they're the same. They're not even close. They're not even close.
That is the time to assert yourself. I seriously cannot sit here and say that if you fall into the light, down in the life of you, or even if you're way past all that and into the soul school and all that stuff, I don't think it's easy to get out. Now, can you? Yeah, but your memory's most likely been wiped.
How would he know that? How would he know if you can get out at that point at all? And if it's just about consent, why can't you just not give consent and leave at any point? If it's just about consent, you should be able to leave at any point during this. Even he doesn't believe that, really. He thinks it's hard to get out at a certain point, which is true. When you're under that euphoric love bomb or light or whatever, you're basically fucked at that point. Am I saying it's impossible? No, I can't say that. I don't know that. Neither does he. He's making claims that he can't back up with jack shit. I just want to add this. Unfortunately, there's a lot of people in this quote community that want lies. They prefer that to the truth. They don't care about evidence. They care. They like the big claims with no evidence. They like all that shit. Okay? I call them truther sheep. That's what they are. They're truther sheep. They're followers. They're cult followers of this shit. All right? They're cult followers of creatures.
Which leads me to the other thing. I see memory wipes in near-death experiences. It's insane. First off, we have admissions of them. Okay? Admissions. Okay.
Okay. Okay. We have admissions of it. Okay. Okay. Well, guess what, dude? Memory wipes? Is that consent? Is that consent? Does that add up with your whole consent theory? Getting your memory wiped? Is that consent? His shit doesn't add up. And you know what? The truther sheep, the cult followers, just gobble it up at the trough. You know, they'll gobble up whatever this thing feeds them.
And I will bring examples for that down the road. But there are clear-cut examples where we see that, okay? So they are applying the memory right. So what? That puts in the question almost every near-death experience, okay? The fact that people are not questioning anything as it pertains to the insanity of this realm, even, you know, just, we've talked about before, like the satanic agenda and narratives and all the craziness that goes on here. Nothing about the power structure, nothing. My life is really difficult. I don't know why I did this or thing.
All right. I agree with that point that the NDEers are naive. They are unaware of this realm. They don't question how things work here. They don't question the evil Illuminati pyramid, the Satanists and Luciferians at the top, and all of the abuse of children. They don't bring up any of that stuff that I've seen with near-death experiencers, the vast, vast majority, okay? At least on the videos on YouTube, the near-death experiencers that are on these channels that are interviewed and giving their testimony about their experience. But how's this guy adding up the memory wipe with consent? How do you reconcile that? I'm going to pause here for a moment and let you really think that over. The defenders of this thing. I want you to really think about that. Really think about it. Give it a little think. In case you forgot what I said already, memory wipe equals consent? How so? How does that add up? See how I'm dismantling what this creature is pushing? Are you starting to see? I hope so, because my channel's not the same as his. I don't just question this realm, I question these creatures on YouTube, which no one else seems to really be doing in the quote soul trap community. So there's a lot of people that come to my channel that just keep pushing, don't do these videos, don't do that, don't do that. You're questioning quote truthers and truth channels. I'm exposing frauds, liars, deceivers, not just grifters. Liars, deceivers that are pushing, that are gaslighting you, telling you that you consented. You just don't remember. That's gaslighting. Some of you don't get it. I don't know what's wrong with you. I really don't. Because 1 + 1 = 2. It's that basic. It's very simple to see. It's very clear. I'm showing it. I'm giving you all kinds of proof to show it. And some of you still won't get it. I can't save everyone. And that's what's really, it's just, it's sad. It's frustrating. It really does frustrate me. Because I can't believe, how did you get to that level? What did you do? What did you follow, or what did you consume your whole life? Were you gobbling up shit your whole life? Filling your head with shit? Like going for every type of brainwashing you can go after? Eating just tubes of toothpaste by the case? What did you do to get to that level where you can't see this when it's pointed out and explained to you? It's frustrating to me. I wonder what, like, are you a totally different species than me? There has to be something. Some explanation. There's something really wrong there if you don't get it. I didn't need anybody to show me and expose this guy to me. I did it myself, and I wasn't believed, as I said last summer when I was being banned. I was exposing this creature. I was talking about how a lot of what he pushes doesn't add up. Did anyone over there agree with me? Not really, no. Not back then. Some of them might start to see it now. They're a little late. And they really don't apologize for the most part to me for, you know, attacking me for speaking the truth all these months. I didn't just speak it once last summer, but speaking it this whole time. 6, 7, 8 months, 9 months. So yeah, that's how things work in the quote truth community. You know who gets attacked the most? The real truth speakers. By the crowd, the followers, you know, that hang out in this shit. Right in here. Here's where you'll find them, okay? And they usually have the wrench. And there's a few of them that have come, including this one, that have come over to my channel that have the wrench. They're moderators, okay? Jimmy hasn't been over to my channel yet. Maybe he's afraid of, you know, what Mark would do if he found out, you know. Maybe Mark would shame him or something. I don't know. I don't know what would happen, but moderators from this creature's channel are curious. What's going on over there at the sanity machine? Well, what's going on my channel is truth. And what's going on here is he's pushing bullshit and lies and making claims with no evidence and all kinds of stuff. That's what's going on over here. And they'll say, but he's got more followers. That's right. He has followers. And I don't want followers. I've said that before. I want thinkers. Some in this quote community even demonize that. They demonize thinking and using your mind. Just think with your heart. See with your heart. Turn your mind off. Well, you turn your mind off and you're going to be following creatures like this. That's where you're going to be, okay? And you're going to be headed right for the recycling bin. It's not me saying that to be mean. I'm giving you the warning that people that care about you should be giving you the warning. They don't, though. I'm saying things to you that other people won't say. In most cases, that's what I think. I bet most people have never said that to you, that you're headed for the recycling bin if you follow shit. That's where you're headed. That's where you're headed. You know what? I would tell you the same thing if you had a fast car, a really fast car. I'm talking about a super fast car with maybe a rocket or something on the back of it. And I'm talking about super fast, where you can go over 300 miles per hour and you're aimed right at a cliff. I would say to you, dude, you're aimed at a cliff. It's half a mile away. You're going to be there in no time flat at that speed. Don't do it. I'm giving you the warning. And people think that's mean. Oh, you're so mean. I mean when I'm telling you that you're headed for the recycling bin? No, I'm not. I'm giving you the warning. You better wake up. You better start seeing. You better change. You better not just see this, but you better open your mind a little wider to truth. You better get some discernment and realize what's happening here. But you also better open your mind more to truth. Because cult followers not only have closed minds, they have tremendous bias and emotional attachment and emotional bias, where whatever lies this creature says, you want to believe. And then you hear my voice and say, he sounds angry, so I don't want to believe anything he says. That's the way you are. But, you know, oh, man, how can I put it? The truth doesn't always come across soft-spoken and sweet, like sweet little lies. You know that song? I believe it's Fleetwood Mac. Either that or it's Stevie Nicks. Tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies. That's what most of you like. Not all of you. There's exceptions. I know I could name you some that I know prefer the truth, even if it's harsh, even if it stings, even if it hurts, even if it's not what you want to believe to be happening. You prefer the truth to the comfortable, sweet little lies. But I'll tell you one thing. There's a lot in this quote community. There's always thousands that prefer those sweet little lies that sound nice. Like, oh, we have to give our consent to all this. Well, where the fuck are you? You're here with me in this realm. We're all here. So you're saying you consented to all this? Do you think adults or children that, or adults that were abused as children consented to that? What about men and women that were raped and tortured? You think they consented to come here to experience, to quote, experience that? You really believe that? Then you're so mind-controlled and mind-warped that you need a lot of help. You know, it does get me worked up. It does, because I know what I know what it must take for you to make you believe that shit. You must be really far gone. I'm not kidding. I'm just telling the truth here. And it's not something these shill channels will say. They'll never say that to their viewers, that they must be far gone. Or that they're fucked up. They don't want to lose one subscriber. They're worried about that. They're worried about building the subscriber count. Okay, this. The 12.1 thousand subscribers and growing by the month. That's what they're worried about. You know what I'm worried about? The truth. Not if somebody unsubscribes. I'm worried about the truth. People unsubscribe from my channel every week, probably at least one or two per day, and new people come. So they drops down and it goes up and down. So that's the way it is. Some people hear something here and they can't take it. Because it doesn't sound, quote, nice. It's not what they want to hear. They want, tell me lies, tell me sweet little lies. That's what they want. That's what they want. I don't care if they call themselves awake, quote, awake, or quote, truthers. I don't give a shit what stupid label they use. I go by their behavior. They hear some harsh truth and they're out, they're gone. It's the way it is.
Things like that. But. The point is there's just a blind acceptance because they have the goggles on of the love bomb. They have the goggles on, assuming what they're dealing with is something like God, something like Jesus, Muhammad, etc. Okay?
Okay, I'm either going to end this video or maybe I'm going to skip ahead a bit and try to find something that's more relevant to what we're talking about here, because this is hours long, almost 3 hours long, and I'm not going to go through this whole thing. I've already proven my point at this point, long before the 59-minute mark, all right? Long ago. So if you don't get it, then you really have mental issues, and I'm not kidding. I'm not exaggerating. I'm not insulting you by saying that. It really is the truth.
If someone, there's nothing wrong with questioning everything. That's what it's all about. Right? It's all about questioning everything. All right. That's what this.
Just a moment, jumping in here. It's all about questioning everything, except if you question this. If you question this thing, it doesn't like that. It doesn't like that. Because then you're taking some shekels out of its pockets, and beyond shekels, you're taking some power away from it, because it wants to be a cult leader, and it wants to have a cult of followers.
Crazy ass reality has come to. You have to question every damn thing, all right? But don't give away your power, okay? Don't think that you do not have the control at the time of death, okay? It's just take the sovereign approach, okay? Become informed, do your research on your own. And go for the sovereign and liberated path. That's just the safe option. The first one is a hell of an example. And it's going to show her basically saying, you know, I agree. But she's also going to drop some interesting information about who she was dealing with too. And I'm probably
gonna end it here. He's saying that she agreed, so he thinks that proves his whole thing that we consented. There's many other times in videos that he said we consent, that it's all about consent, that quote, we all consented to this. He has pushed this consent false narrative over and over and over again. And even some of his former moderators can admit to that much. Okay? They're starting to open their eyes. Not all of them, but some of them have come over to my channel and they're starting to see what this thing has been pushing. Did they catch on as quickly as me? No. And is that my ego saying it? No. Because I wish they had caught on last summer. I wish all this didn't go on. I've been made the enemy, the bad guy, and everything else, but you know, I'm fine with being banned. Let's put it this way. I'm fine with being banned from every fucking YouTube channel that there is that's part of the, quote, truth community. They can all ban me if they want to. All of them. I'll stand alone against them all. And I said that last summer. I'm saying it. I said it last year. I'm saying it this year. If I'm alive next year, I'll say it next year. You get what I'm saying? When I get out of this matrix, I'll still be saying the same thing. I'll still be standing for the truth. When they talk about, it's laughable when they talk about, oh, question everything. Just don't question the consent bullshit that you all seem to be on the same page. This creature, Dan from Overwatch, Wayne Bush, and the other lesser known, quote, soul trap channels. Except for Vince, that's one that is not on board with the quote, we consented bullshit narrative. But it sure seems like the rest are. All right? And a lot of the, well, anyways, I'm not going to go on and on forever with this forever con man bullshit. This creature, this creepy boy. Excuse me. I'm going to end this video soon. It almost makes me sick to listen to that voice. I'm not exaggerating, okay? Maybe I will have to buy software. I don't want to cover this shit anymore, though. It's sickening to me. It's not just the voice. It's the deceit. It's the whole thing. It's the energy of that thing. It's all of it. It's the whole creature. The voice is part of it, all right? That was a part of it from the beginning. I watched that. I found it difficult from the very first video when I first went on there. And when I first went on that channel, that creature's creepy boy channel, I was already well aware of the Soul Trap years before I got on there. I only got on there last year, 2022. I was only on here for six months or I don't know, something like that. And I had to push through to continue to listen to that voice and watch any of the videos. It was difficult. But then once you really see what it is and you just dislike the thing, it's even worse to listen to that voice when you can't stand the freaking creature. It's worse, okay? But he didn't, the people that say, well, didn't he wake you up to the, no, he didn't wake me up to the Soul Trap. I was aware of it before then. I was aware of it even before I came across Overwatch, Dan's channel. And Dan might as well be Siamese twins. They're attached at the hip now. They're buddies, and they're both on the same page, pushing the same shit. Dan didn't seem to push the we consented before, but he does now. He does now, that's for sure. So, there you go. And, okay, so did I mention Dan pushes the we consented? I had responded, this is me, the Sanity Machine. I had commented a year ago on his channel. It changes your name on YouTube when you change your name. It retroactively changed my name. I used to be Abstract Angel Artist when I posted this comment a year ago on one of Dan's videos on his channel, Overwatch channel on YouTube. And he replied. There are a bunch of replies, 14 replies. And I put consented to be here ? Because I'm questioning things which they don't like. They talk about questioning things. They don't like that though. Yes, people are tricked into consent. Well, tricked automatically disqualifies it from being consent, Dan. You can't be forced to be here. Well, then how come there's so many pre-birth memories like Harold's and others and near-death experiences talking about forced to be here and forced back into a body? Here's my response to his shit and to someone else, this person. I didn't consent to any of this shit. And look, 4 people liked that comment. So I'm not the only one that sees this. And that was a year ago. There's a growing number, okay? This was a year ago. See that? 1 year ago. There's a growing number of us. There's a lot more now than there were a year ago. And it's growing. That don't buy the we consented. It's mind control. So the people that get upset on my channel about what I'm saying, I can back up what I'm saying with evidence. And I've just done it tonight. I did it again, and I'll continue to do it. So you have issues with who you trust and who you don't trust. You have things asked backwards. You're trusting the wrong people, and you're distrusting people that are showing you the truth and can back up their claims. You have things asked backwards. All right? That's not to everyone watching this. That's to the people that keep leaving the same fucking comments, defending the shills, defending the creatures, defending the deceivers, the liars, pushing a false narrative. I'm going to end this video. It's gone on for a while. I proved my point about multiple people, including this guy. Okay? See this guy here? He's been interviewed multiple times on Forever Con Men Creatures channel. All right? So I've shown what they are. You have the evidence. Now what are you going to do? You going to leave some more rude comments? Going to imply that I'm lying? That I don't have the evidence? That you don't recall him saying this? You've been shown. You don't have the excuse anymore. It's gone. I took it away. Gone.